Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's been 6 freaking months since I haven't been on here. Sucks. So today I'm here to do something I've never done before, but so excited to do because I've always wanted to do a video like this. I'm gonna be doing an reaction video. Lately people do reaction videos to albums and I wanted to, but I was just kind of like, I don't know what album to do because some albums are out right now, but then there's like some old albums I've been wanting to do, so I just couldn't really like choose. So talking to Daquan, he was like, you should do like a reaction video to like pick like at least like 2 artists or like one, and do like every like just like one track off of like each album. And I was like, that's a good idea. So today I'm gonna be doing Ariana Grande and Lana Del Rey. The reason why I'm doing Ariana Grande is because I've been a fan of her for a very long time and she just keeps getting better and better and better. Doing Lana Del Rey also is because I love Lana Del Rey. She's my favorite singer. I need to see her once in my lifetime. It has to be once in this lifetime, Lana. You might not be watching this, but if you do, know that. So yeah, it's gonna be from every 3rd track. We're gonna start with Ariana Grande. I'm gonna be starting from like the first album, 3rd track. Second album, 3rd track. No, not second album. Yeah, until like their last one. So I'm doing like every 3rd track that they had on their album. And I'm doing the same with Lana Del Rey. But the only difference with Lana Del Rey is that I'm doing every like 5 tracks. So whatever 5 track is on Lana Del Rey's albums, I'm gonna do that. So we're gonna get started. Oh, and this is my apartment, by the way. I wanted to vlog like when I was moving in, but it was kind of like was in it. Very, very T-spine. Gonna get started. We're gonna start with Ariana Grande, called Right There. It's featuring Big Sean. It's from her first album, Yours Truly. I actually do like this song. It's a really, really good song. So I'll just see what song I like better from each album. So here's Right There. These vocals, the vocals, 100%. She was like, this was her first album, and it's just crazy. She was going the fuck off, and she really went off. Big Sean had his little, you know, 2 little verses in together at this time, I believe so, in this era. So this was from Yours Truly, the 3rd track. Onto the Be One Last Time, and it's gonna be from My Everything. So this is the 3rd track, on My Everything one last time. Here we go. To pause real quick because it's a really good song. At first, I don't know, I wasn't like really listening to it. I guess it was like really mainstream, so when it calmed down a little bit, that's when I started listening to it, and I was like, damn, her vocals are really good on the song. She really went off. Do I like that song better than Right There? Maybe, most likely. Only because Right There is like a really, really good song. But One Last Time, it was just like, you know, it was just like, it was Ariana Grande. Like, it was just like her. Like, growing, you know. And she went off and. This next one's gonna be from Thank You Next. The third track from Thank You Next is gonna be NASA. From Thank You Next, track, the third track from Thank You Next. What can I say? Of course, it was a bop. It was a really good song. I do like it better than Right There, but I don't like it from better. Like, I don't like it better from One Last Time, unfortunately. I really like the song. It's a really good vibe. Like, you know, like. You know, like, when you, like, feel happy and shit, you want to listen to NASA or a song like NASA. Or you want to listen to Ariana Grande, but I like to listen to this song. My niece also likes it, so that's why I also like it a lot. Because my niece likes it. And she'd be cute. I would kind of backwards on the Ariana Grande. NASA was supposed to be the last. So it's gonna be Alright and The Light Is Coming. Be Alright's from Dangerous Woman, that era. I love that era, actually. It's probably my favorite era from her. I don't know if I'm gonna like this song better than the last three, like, all together, but this is Be Alright, and third track in Dangerous Woman. Pause. I like the choreography she does on her performance. That's the only time I could really listen to the song, is if I'm watching that performance. She goes off on that performance. This is like a truly like an Ariana Grande fucking song. I could say this is definitely like, I would definitely like the choreography she does to this fucking performance. I just feel like she's saying the same thing over and over again, and that's probably why I'm kind of like, But that was Be Alright. This is The Light Is Coming. It was on Sweetener 2018. This is the third track. It's featuring Nicki Minaj. I don't know if I like that song better than the last three. I might like it better than Be Alright. But I kind of feel the same about it. I really like Nicki's part though. And Ari, she went out, like, I like the way, like, I like the vibe. It was kind of just like, she was saying the same thing, like, Be Alright. So be wiped out, you won me. Until you had to find out it's one me. But he said, you don't know because you know what I think. With the name Bosky, how do you do things? A tropical green, how do you do Light Is Coming featuring Nicki Minaj on Sweetener. I do like it better than Be Alright. I have to say Be Alright's probably my least favorite from like this little section. I love Nicki's part. She went off. I like the fact that they always collab somehow, like on their albums, and I'm just like, yes, I love it. I think The Light Is Coming, it's like a cute little vibe. Like, I just have to be in the mood for that. Like, I have to be in the mood for that type of vibe. Bitch, I had to have that little moment because now we're about to do Lana Del Rey. Kind of have to wear all black because it's Halloween time. Just like a queen, like a goddess in black. I don't know. I just wear black when I listen to her most of the time. When I wear black and you see me around, that's how you know I'm just having one of those days where I'm just jamming to Lana. So that was Ariana Grande. Now we're gonna get to Lana Del Rey. For Lana Del Rey, it's gonna be a little different, just a little bit. I'm gonna be doing the fifth track of every album instead of the third, like I did with Ariana Grande's. With Lana, her songs tend to be a little long. That's why I like it. It's like a never lasting song. And her voice is just like, it's amazing. The first album's gonna be from Born to Die. The first album's gonna be Born to Die. The fifth track is gonna be Dying Mountain Dew. It's a pretty good song. Honestly, I love this whole album, like from top to bottom. I really didn't have like a least favorite, like, cause this whole out, like all of the songs, you can just like feel it and like, I can't explain. I could go on and on, but I'm not. That was Lana Del Rey, but that was like the start. She has like a real good voice, and the type of music she sings goes so good with it. And the fact that she does it pretty much all, like, she has her sister directing most of the time, and she's like songwriting. It's just like, wow, like, it's just so inspiring. Second track's gonna be from Paradise. It was kind of like it was like Born to Die, but it was like a deluxe, really, but it was like a whole different picture and everything. The song's gonna be Gods and Monsters. I gotta say, I love this song. It reminds me of Daquan. Will I like it better than Dying Mountain Dew? don't know, this is my first time listening to like all of these songs, honestly, like back to back like this. But here's From Paradise, the track number 5 from Paradise, Gods and Monsters. That was Gods and Monsters. That song reminds me of Daquan. He really loves that song. It was this one time I also had it on, and my niece was like kind of dancing to it, and I was like, girl, like, ooh, girl, because was she saying that song? But I do like Ethan Diamondu. I do love Diamond Dew, but Gods and Monsters kind of had to take the cake. So for the next album, it's going to be from Ultraviolet. This was her third album, or fourth album, because Paradise really don't, like, it counts, but it does, like, it just does, I don't know anymore. But this is West Coast. It's kind of why I got on black in the first place. This album was very, like, dark. I fucking loved it. Like, this is from Ultraviolet. The fifth track is gonna be West Coast. Ladies and gentlemen, Lana Dury. Really love this song. Even though she, it's like kind of like a NASA thing, because like, no, not NASA, like a Be Alright, because she kind of said like the same thing. And they, like it was a good vibe, but it's different because like, I don't know. Lana brings that vibe. I'm always in a vibe for her. So the next track is gonna be from Honeymoon. It's gonna be High by the Beach. That is a really, really good song. And we're kind of at our checkpoint because this is like her fifth album. And yeah, this song is really good. Like, it was so different. Just hate. That was High by the Beach by Lana Del Rey. That was on Honeymoon. This album was pretty, it was like kind of like hip-hop-y. And that's what kind of made it like an even more better vibe. And it coming from Lana Del Rey, kind of don't like expect a song like this, but, or you, it just really depends. But when I first heard it, I was like, fuck, she. And at the time, I was even a smoker. So that's what made it kind of like, you know. So the next one's gonna be Lust for Life album. It's gonna be Summer Bummer featuring A$AP Rocky. Mom and Dad. If y'all don't know, A$AP Rocky's my favorite rapper. Playboi Carti's also on here too. He's like I guess he like produced it, and he you can also like kind of hear him in the back. But this song was like a good song. It's a hip hop song, like it's hip hoppy. If it Lana and A$AP really good, and Playboi Carti did his thing. If like he did his thing, but here it is. It's never too late. Make you want to quit the bitch you dating. Those vocals to end out that song. Oh, Jesus. Right now, I'm starting to feel this vibe. Like, it was like. The album cover was just so fucking cute. Like, ugh. Next stopping point. Almost their stopping point, because Lana Del Rey. This is from her last album, Norman Effin Rockwell. It was a cover. It was a to Sublime. I listen to Sublime. I don't know if y'all do, but I do. And I know it's some people that do, or some people that know of them, of course. But she did a cover to that. Some Sublime fans were mad, but us Lana Del Rey fans were kind of expecting it. It was weird, but I mean, we like her version. I also like Sublime's version. I like both of their versions. And most of the Lana Del Rey fans do too. Like, why can't they just let those songs just be? If you don't like it, don't listen to it. Don't talk about it. But you know, it's the internet, they're stupid. This is from Norman Effin Rockwell, Doing Time. This was the fifth track from this album. She snapped, like, I really love this, like, I really love the fact she did a cover to a Sublime song. Kind of never seen it coming, but then again, I wasn't disappointed, like, when I first heard about it, or when I first heard it. I was just kind of like, oh, wow, like, someone's bringing back, like, the Sublime legacy doing the cover. But anyways, honestly, guys, I don't know what song from Lana Del Rey, like, I really like from all five tracks of each album. It's really hard because you have Diamond Mountain Dew, The Start, then you have Gods and Monsters, like, and then West Coast, High by the Beach, some of them Doing Time. I didn't think it was gonna be this hard, like. Because I know from Ariana Grande, I said One Last Time just took the cake. But when it comes to Lana Del Rey, when it comes to any of her top, like, top three, and they asked me for one, I'm like, I honestly don't know, because it's just so hard. I don't know what song I was feeling the most. Yeah, I might have to go with West Coast. Only because like that song was like a real good, like it's like a real good vibe, and West Coast took the cake. It was hard for me to decide though. But West Coast took the cake, and it'd be like that sometimes. But I love all the other ones. Like, it was just so hard. From Ariana Grande, it really wasn't hard. But it's hard for Lana.
I have a Lana dance break.
So I had to do that dance break because Lana had the best part on that song. That's the only reason why I kind of like it. And I like the chorus. Ariana Grande's part was alright. I'm not going to mention Miley. But anyways, I'm signing off now. But I will be doing more videos. Trust me, because I can now. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I'm going to put my Instagram and my Twitter in the description. You can ask me questions there if you want to or give me ideas on what I should do for my next vlog. Thank you for watching. If you are, bless you. God bless everyone, and see you soon.